Good morning. This is Pastor Jim Hardy, pastor of First Presbyterian Church in Lockport, New York. Today is April 27th, 2020. I'm going to be reading from Matthew 12. Hear the word of the Lord. And at that time, Jesus went through the grain fields on the Sabbath. His disciples were hungry, and they began to pluck heads of grain and to eat. And when the Pharisees saw it, they said to him, "Look, your disciples are doing what is not lawful to do on the Sabbath." And he said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he and his companions were hungry? He entered the house of God and ate the bread of the presence, which is not lawful for him or his companions to eat, but only for the priests. Or have you not read in the law that on the Sabbath the priests in the temple break the Sabbath and yet are guiltless? I tell you, something greater than the temple is here. And if you had known what this means, 'I desire mercy and not sacrifice,' you would have not condemned the guiltless, for the Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." So, this passage, Jesus is confronting the Pharisees. The Pharisees were generally conservative Jews, Jewish followers at the time of Jesus in the first century. They were a minority sect in the in Israel, but they had some predominance and some authority and power. They basically had a stricter reading of the Torah and the law, particularly when it came to following things like eating and cleanliness, ritual cleanliness. And so Jesus was confronting the Pharisees over just the issue of the observance of the Sabbath, and particularly when it came to doing some work, or in this case, plucking grain from to eat. And Jesus just reminds them of what is found in Scripture, the idea that "I desire mercy and not sacrifice," that the important thing of religious traditions, the important thing of belief, the important thing of faith is mercy. And that mercy and showing compassion is the most and prominent characteristic of what it means to be a follower, ultimately a follower of Jesus. One needs to be compassionate. One needs to show mercy. And I think that this is an opportunity for all of us to show compassion and show mercy by reaching out to those who are facing difficult and challenging times. There's a lot of emotion going on right now. Some people are getting frustrated and impatient with the state of being locked in at home. Some people are just becoming angry and wondering why we can't reopen the economy. Some people are just frustrated. But we also have to remind ourselves of the importance of compassion and mercy, for there are many people that are still vulnerable to this epidemic. There are people that are still struggling with this epidemic, and people are still dying daily from this epidemic. So we need to balance our frustrations and our anger with compassion and mercy for those who are struggling, and trying to find ways to reach out to those who are struggling, maybe reaching out by contacting them, calling them, FaceTiming them, Zooming them, writing cards to them, sending love and prayers their way. This past weekend, I celebrated with many individuals, friends, a socially distant birthday party for a 99-year-old woman, a woman who would be very vulnerable if she were to catch the COVID-19. This ultimately would probably struggle greatly with that. And the compassion that was shown to her by by celebrating her birthday, but also being responsible was an important reminder of the mercy and compassion of those who love her. Jesus calls us to be compassionate. Jesus calls us to put mercy and compassion over law. And ultimately, that is what it means to follow Jesus, to show mercy and compassion. Sacrifice is less important than mercy in Jesus' teaching. Following the law literally is less important than showing love for those in need. Being able to be a lover of those around us is more important than following the exact letter of the law. Let us pray. Dearest Lord, we'd ask that you'd bless us and guide us in these times. Help us to be patient and to have compassion and mercy for those who are in need. Lift us up with your grace and love. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior.